Okay, so let's talk about these columns. The name column is a fixed column and it will always appear off to the left of all the other columns. To rename a clip, highlight it and press the return key. When you are in list view, there are 7 default columns when you start out with a new project. With the exception of the name column, you can remove a column by right-clicking on a column heading and choosing a column heading that you would like to hide. So, for example, if I don't care about the ending timecode value for my clips, I can choose to hide that particular column. To resize a column, just grab onto the edge of the column heading and drag it to the left or right. You can also add additional information in some columns, like the notes column. To add a note, click under the column heading for a particular clip. Then move your mouse cursor to the right or left and click again. This is important because if you press the return key, Final Cut Pro 10 will assume you are renaming the clip instead of adding a note. You can also reposition columns by dragging the column heading to the left or right. For myself, I like having the duration column next to the name column. Columns can also be sorted in ascending or descending order. To sort a column, just click on the column heading. Clicking on the name column will sort things alphabetically in ascending or descending order. A down arrow indicates you're sorting in descending order, and an up arrow indicates you are sorting in ascending order. For myself, I often sort my clips by their duration so I can see the amount of media I've got to work with.